You see, sometimes in life, we make moments too big, and we put everything on that moment. This is my big shot. I have to do it, or else I can't get through. Here's the thing. If you find that you're going to the same situation where you feel like you have all this pressure and it can become crippling sometimes and you want to find a way to cope with it, this next podcast is for you. We're looking at not making that moment too big, because if you do, it can cripple you. And so hopefully you will be encouraged, you will be inspired to find a new way of dealing with your situation so that way you can continue to enjoy what you do and to keep moving forward. I'm Rick Roberts, and you stay classy. Bye. Hey peeps, I'm Rick Roberts, and this is Rick Roberts Life, the podcast where we talk about my faith, my thoughts, my life. And today is Motivation Monday, and I want to talk to you about something that seems to get to me, and I think that if it gets to me, it might also affect you. The phrase for today is, don't make it too big. When it comes to the things that we want to do in life, the things that we want in life, we tend to put so much pressure when it seems like we might be able to get a part of it or be able to do something in it. And since we put so much pressure on it, it makes it where it becomes a weight on us, and it becomes a thing where it's very difficult and brings a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and it can become crippling if you're not careful with the amount of pressure you put on yourself because you make it too big. The whole idea is that each and every little thing that you do is bringing you one step closer towards your greatest success. And so everything you're doing now is bringing you closer. This job interview, this event you have coming up, whatever it is that you're doing is only part of the picture. It's not the picture. This is not everything. This is not your whole be-all and end-all. This is only one piece to the big puzzle. And so what I'm saying to you is, be careful not to make it too big, because if you make it too big, it's going to be very difficult for you to cope with it. And that's something that I'm working on myself. You know, I want to do so much in this life. You know, I want to be able to reach out and help, you know, inspire and encourage so many people. And sometimes I make things too big in my mind, and I put too much pressure on it. And I have to say to myself, Rick, calm down. It's just this. Now, I typically talk, you know, about not saying, oh, it's just this, because when you say just that, it's like you're taking away from it. But in this case, it's okay to say it's just a podcast. It's just a fitness class. It's just a sermon. It's just, you know, a conference. Whatever it is that I'm doing, if I'm starting to feel the weight of it in a negative way, I need to then put myself in the right perspective to what I'm doing and say, you know what? This is not the be-all and end-all of what it is that I'm here to do. You know, I'd love for people to say in 5 years' time that that was an amazing thing that happened. But the reality is that for people to remember this 5 years from now, it's not likely that that's going to be a thing that happens where everyone's going to have a lasting impression for the next 5 years on this one particular thing. But what I want people to do is to look at the body of work that I've done and to be able to remember that and remember the idea of what it is I'm looking to do and to impart to the world. And so that's the same thing for you, hopefully, is that the work that you do is going to be enough to help leave a positive change on those around you. And I want you to be careful not to put too much on any one given moment, because if you do, if you make it too big, it can make it where you don't enjoy what it is that you're doing, you're not able to really be your authentic self, and you start to find yourself feeling like an imposter because this moment's bigger than yourself. It's natural to make each moment so big because you want it so much. It's a natural thing to do. And so a lot of people fall into this trap where they make it so big where it becomes crippling in a sense. You're not alone in that. What I want to encourage you to do is to realize that you're doing this because you care about this. You're doing this because it's important to you. And it may not be important to every single body on this planet, but it's also important to somebody else. And as you continue to keep working and to keep pouring out into what is so important to you, you're going to find the right people that can connect with what you're doing. And they will be your loyal followers and support the work that you're doing because they get it, they understand it, and they see the need for what it is that you're doing. And so keep working, keep doing a great job so that way you can find the people that connect with you and can support what it is that you're doing. Keep in mind, there are billions of people on this planet. The world is open because we have the internet. And so it is very silly to think that you're not going to find a group of people that understand your vision and can support what it is that you're looking to do, because there's so many people out there. And what you're doing makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Like, if it's important to you and you're willing to put all on the line and to hang with it and not give up, then you're going to find your people. It's just, you know, a matter of when, not if, but when. So take that pressure off of yourself and realize that this isn't about you. This is about the passion you have. This is about the purpose you're building. And so keep developing yourself. Keep developing your skills. Keep using your talents. And as you mature in what it is that you're doing, the right people who will appreciate you will find you, as long as you keep putting in the work. But don't make each moment so big that it cripples you, that it crushes you, that it takes away from the enjoyment of what it is that you're doing, because it's such an easy thing to do. Like I said, it's a common thing to do. I've fallen, you know, victim to it, and I'm learning to not do it so much. And so I know you can do the same thing. I know you can find your way out of falling into that same trap by managing how big you're making this moment, because this moment is only a piece of the picture of what it is you're looking to do. Okay? Keep your head up, keep working hard, and keep moving forward. You've got this. Okay? You've got this. If that person, if that group, if whatever it is that you're looking to do doesn't accept what you're doing, continue to build it by yourself, and the right people will come along. Don't quit. Don't give up on what matters most to you. If it matters that much to you, keep fighting for it. Keep working for it. If it takes you a year, if it takes you 5 years, if it takes you a decade, you will still get there, but you just have to keep working hard. Okay? I believe in you. You can do this. You've got this. Another reason why we make the moment so big is because we put our own self-worth into that moment as well. Like, if we don't do well, then it says something bad about us. And I want you to be careful of that. Just because you're doing something and it means a lot to you, and maybe you're pouring yourself into this, if people don't appreciate that, if you mess up, it doesn't mean that you're any less of a person. You know, you are still a remarkable person. At least you tried something, and at least you're growing and maturing in something. Just because it may not work out, or just because there's a possibility of failure, doesn't mean that you're going to fail. It doesn't mean that you're any less valuable as a person if you do fail. Your value is not determined by how well you perform. Your value should come from inside here. Your character is so important. As long as you have a solid character, as long as you know your values and you know yourself, what you're doing will not determine your value. Now, of course, when you talk about the marketplace, yes, people will pay depending on how valuable they see it. But value in the marketplace is all about perception. You do not need to tie your self-worth to what people see. Your self-worth must come from inside first. You must see your value first. You are remarkable. You are wonderful. You can do a lot of great things. This moment is not going to determine that. This moment is only going to reveal how great you are. That's all it is. And if you don't shine there, you're gonna shine later. Your time will come. Don't quit. Don't put too much on this moment, because it's not the be all and end all. Okay? Okay? All right. This conversation is when you take it in a negative direction and it starts to make it where you feel like you are not capable of doing a good job, that you are not able to get good sleep, you're not able to get good rest, you're not able to have peace in yourself because you feel like this is too big. And that's why I say don't make it too big. Keep it in perspective. Every single thing you're doing is part of the greater puzzle, part of the greater picture. And as you're working, your body of work will speak about what it is you're looking to do, and not just that one moment. Okay? So continue to keep doing a great job. Continue to keep moving forward and realize that don't make it too big. If you mess up, it happens. You have to learn from your mistakes. If you do a great job, fantastic. It just lets you know that, you know, you are capable and that you are meant to be doing what you're meant to be doing. Okay? So keep moving forward. And like I said, regardless of what happens, if this means that much to you, as long as you persevere and you keep working towards where you need to be, you will get there in the end. You know, the people who are successful are the ones that refuse to give up. They're the ones that continue to keep moving forward, even though it seemed like everything was stacked against them. You know, they lost their homes, they lost everything else, but they kept moving forward. And because they were persistent, because they refused to give up, they were able to stand the test of time and to be able to say, look, I'm here to stay. I've made it. I know what it's like to live out my car. I know what it's like to live in a mansion. And regardless of what I'm living in, I'm going to keep doing what I love to do because this means so much to me. I'm Rick Roberts, and you stay classy. Bye.